Oh yeah, it's time for another episode of Fantastic Fictional Fight Scenes, and today we're going to talk about Star Trek, the original series, and, I got a red shirt on. Gotta wash my back, but today we're watching the episode Arena, specifically the fight scene between Kirk and the Gorn, the lizard-like race of hostile aliens that the Enterprise meets and gives chase to, and then a super intelligent, omniscient alien force transports Kirk and the captain of the Gorn ship to a planet to fight to the death to prove something. What? Watch that episode. Let's take a look at the fight scene right now. The Gorn comes out with a big stick. Kirk gives it a look. Oh my, what is this thing? Kirk sees the Gorn is moving rather slowly. The Gorn swings that dry stick, which breaks against the tree. As Kirk dodges behind the tree, the Gorn don't need no stick. Slow motion swing and the double hammer fist, Kirk's signature move. Hiya! The judo chop, his other signature move. The Gorn comes forward using a zombie-like strategy, catches Kirk's roundhouse kick and tosses him like a small child fighting his dad. Kirk has now realized the strength of his reptilian adversary. Gets up to assess the situation. He's got plenty of time. It's moving slowly, but they move into a clinch. Looks like the Gorn is attempting to bite. Kirk does something really smart, like seriously really smart right here. He's cross-facing up against the neck, up against the chin to make some space. If somebody clinches with you, if you're in a clinch you don't like, you can cross-face with both hands like Kirk is doing right here. This is a really smart move. And then he does the double slap to the ears to discombobulate the Gorn. Kirk runs up into the mountain to grab a rock, picks up this rock. That's a pretty big rock for a human to carry, if it wasn't styrofoam, but let's just pretend it's real. He brings it up over his head, and he throws it. He hits the Gorn, but to no effect. Kirk is supposed to be stronger than the average man. He's a prime physical specimen of humanity in these movies. But the Gorn is much, much stronger. The Gorn grabs a rock, which would weigh a lot, like a ton, and just good morning lifts that up, lifts it up over his head, and then heaves it up the mountainside like 65 feet. Kirk is like, holy crap, I am not going to beat this thing in hand-to-hand combat. The Gorn growls, walks very slowly toward his adversary. And again, that's the hand-to-hand combat portion of the fight. If you watch the whole thing, Kirk eventually figures out how to make a crude cannon with some gunpowder and a big thing of bamboo and some crystal or diamond shards or something like that, and ends up beating the Gorn that way. Which is a whole other thing. I think the Mythbusters did a test to see if that was even physically possible. It turns out, no, not exactly. Not exactly. Kirk would have blown himself apart with that bamboo cannon. Anyway, that's beside the point. Ooh, I love Star Trek. Man. So, what works, what doesn't? Well, if you have a superhuman adversary, nothing really works. Kirk figured that out right away. I can't fight him. I can't damage him. He's too strong. He's too durable. He's just too thick, too hard, too dense. It's not going to work. Even though the Gorn moves extremely slowly, punching that thing, even the might of the double Kirk hammer fist. Man, Kirk-Fu is some serious stuff. Seriously, though, putting your hands together like this and then striking downward. This is, again, one of Kirk's signature moves, and I love Star Trek, but it's a weird thing to do. It's a weird thing that anybody ever thought that this would somehow be more effective than, say, a single hammer fist. Because if one is good, two must be twice as good, right? Well, no, it turns out no. You can't actually put as much power into both at the same time as you can into one. Also, interlocking the fingers like this, if you don't know, is a terrible idea in a fight for a lot of reasons. If you do swing these arms hard enough to do any significant damage, you're probably also going to break every single one of your fingers, so not a good idea. If you're grappling, terrible idea to interlace your fingers, so I'm glad to see Kirk at least didn't do that. But sometimes people will try for a double collar tie, you know, like a Muay Thai clinch behind the head, And beginners will often interlace their fingers, feeling like this is strong. My fingers feel like they're tightly knit together, until the other guy starts moving around and then all of their fingers start to break. Now, what was good about that, when they were in that clinch and Kirk was against a much stronger adversary, he made a frame, a tight frame. And I love that he used a ball and socket frame up against the neck. That is a real thing. That is actually something you can do in a clinch against a much stronger adversary that you can't control. If we make a frame crossface right there up against the chin, we can break our opponent's posture, meaning we either turn the neck up or down or twist it sideways. If there's spinal torsion in the neck, especially when we crossface against the chin, not the neck, but the chin. I know the Gorn's a lizard. It doesn't exactly have a chin like a human. There are very few animals out there that have chins. Humans, elephants, and that's about it. But this is a lever that turns the face around. So if you crossface against it, spinal torsion puts you in a really weak sauce position. So even a much stronger person, if you twist that neck out of alignment, yeah, you can often use that to your advantage to escape a clinch that you don't like. So props to Captain Kirk for some excellent grappling technique right there. All right, folks, if you have questions or suggestions for the next episode of Fantastic Fictional Fight Scenes, please let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. Now get out there and train.